dataset, and the augmented one beat every one of them significantly. So with some tweaking and some more training, you can, I think you can use this to boost your datasets.
Thank you.
Thanks. Any other questions? Either I'm super clear or
otherwise, I'm super...
Yeah?
You mentioned that you or Google or someone used this for gaze estimation.
Yeah.
What is that?
Oh, gaze estimation, that's a good question. So gaze, that's where you're looking.
Yeah, okay, so it's basically estimating the...
Yeah, take a picture of an eye, and right now I've done pupil regression, so take a picture of an eye, find the pupil. That's a subset of gaze estimation, or a part of the process if you do it the way some of us do it. Not telling who. And gaze estimation is just finding where you're looking, given an image of your eye.
Okay, I see. And any of this, do you use any of this in production in any of your models or so?
But I can tell you that we don't, because they're not good enough.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just train some more.
Yeah. At least not these ones. Yeah. Anyone else? Crystal clear then. Great, because one last presentation. So I hope that this talk has made you... Yeah, I should summarize. So we have, as you remember, we have gone through both how to create a GAN and how not to create a GAN. At the end, we have seen some practical examples. In the end, the objective in the beginning was to understand how GANs work. I hope that you all feel that you understand how GANs work. And you should perhaps be equipped to be able to train them now, just sitting at home with your computer. That's at least my idea of a fun Friday night. And also to be amazed. And to me, I don't know about you, but to me, when I got these results, these are very amazing. So now I'll thank you and hope that you feel better equipped to juggle with GANs. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And now we're gonna have a short break of 10 minutes. And then we're going to continue with presentation from David Silverstein.